That is safety. E6, good clinical practice. E8, general considerations for clinical trial. And E9, statistical principles for clinical trials. Then the key members involved in the clinical data management team are clinical data manager, database administrator, database programmer, clinical data coordinator and clinical data associate. Then this is the nutshell of clinical trials. Firstly, we prepare the protocol. That protocol is approved. Then investigator selection is done by the sponsor. Then the whole process is approved. Then the patient recruitment is done and they are asked for the participation through the informed consent form. Then the whatever data we get after the third phase, that is entered and reviewed. Then the whole data in the database is sent to the statistical team to know the results, the final results. Then finally the data is presented and it is approved by the regulatory authority. Then this general process of CDM. So CDM first starts with the planning. The overall protocol, the SOPs and all the clinical trial data forms are approved and signed off, planned and signed off. Then comes the design and development stage. In this stage, the CRF is designed and the database is set up. The database is first checked with the dummy data so that we should know that the whatever the database we have prepared is in accordance with the ICH guidelines or not. Then comes the data management process. As the data the database is set up, then this management start in which we do the discrepancy management. So discrepancies are the errors. Those are auto-generated or which can be major. So the auto-generated discrepancies may be in-house resolved by the CDM management people only. But some which are not resolved are sent to the sites as data clarification forms. Then comes the quality assurance. Quality assurance, as we all know, is